Switch to English one more time for the final remarks. I leave the floor to Zoe Romano. She's the co-founder of WeMake. WeMake is our strategic partner for this two-day event and partner of OpenCare. Thank you, Zoe.
Thank you all. Good late afternoon. We are approaching the concluding session portion of this program. Thank you for staying here until now. I will be brief as I'm the person separating you from the aperitivo taking place in there. I'm really happy to be part of this conference and to see it happen in Milan. In the past 2 years, I met a lot of people visiting this city, and for the first time, or maybe after staying abroad after some year, they came back, and most of them felt a different atmosphere. And today's initiative is an example of the exciting direction that the city is taking together with its citizens. I wanted to take some minutes before we give our attention to the Calls for Solution project to share with you 3 points which I think emerge powerfully today, and we are going to keep discussing, I think, in tomorrow's sessions. First of all, I think that the first point that came out is that cities are and people are at the center of contemporary social innovations. As Manuel Castells taught us, the city is a social product resulting from conflicting social interests and values. Cities are usually shaped by social dominant interests, but as we could see today, in this next generation internet era, major transformations are happening in the city's role, meaning, and structure, especially when the public sphere and the grassroots mobilization are able to create a dialogue and take action together. It seems that in these centuries, cities are becoming more able to be the place where citizens can create a connection with policymakers and get in touch with the res publica, much more than what happened with nation states. Our current model of governance, composed by representative democracy, bureaucracy administration, ruled by appointed expert, is no longer able to face the nature of the challenges that we face. Digital technologies and the proximity we have in the city are helping in enabling greater participation, collaborative decision, and building more trust, which is, I think, a very crucial aspect of care. We didn't talk much about trust today, but I think it's part of every action we take. Open Care project, they gave us the possibility to work with Milan municipality, and we learn a lot from each other. On one side, we could show them what digital social innovation does mean to us, citizens, makers, social innovators, open source advocates. And on the other side, the municipality could show us how complex it is to take care of a city and its citizens, and which challenges we need to face together. The idea of open care is experimenting within this new relation, in a new care system where different actors, expert and non-expert, are in condition to play a relevant role and being recognized publicly. Similar examples are happening in Amsterdam, in London, in Barcelona, and events like this conference allow us to share best practices and learn from each other, fostering the scaling up of projects and bringing the results to a wider public, thanks to the support of the European Commission. The second element is that I think top-down solutions are not effective anymore. One size fits all services and products to solve specific care needs are ineffective to address the diverse interests of local communities around the world. Designers, technologists, makers, and policymakers need to start from local tacit knowledge in order to embed new meanings and perspectives into co-design services and products. The adoption of open principle in software, hardware, data, and design carries great potential because, as we learned earlier, when a technology is perceived as open, people are both empowered and willing to improve upon it, knowing that they will be allowed to use it and be supported in building solutions for their needs, and even acquire the skills to create social businesses on top of it. And I hope in the next months we'll keep investing on this aspect. The third element that I think is crucial also is that all this will not be possible without internet. I have a 15-year-old daughter And sometimes she asks me how we were doing certain things when internet was not here. Actually, I remember those sad days of boring afternoons in a world without internet. And today, actually, is the internet 30th birthday. 40 years ago, there was the first full transmission happening. And it's a nice day that is today. Now, the risk of not having internet again is becoming real. As many of you know, the power of internet is about neutrality. The principle that all traffic on the internet is treated equally, meaning no preferential lanes for those who can pay. Now, a new rule by the US Federal Communication Commission could allow internet service providers like Verizon, Comcast, and AT&T to block apps, slow websites, and charge fees to control what we see and do online. Right now, this fight is happening in the United States, but it could affect also Europe very soon. Violation of net neutrality could compromise an already uneven distribution of broadband across Europe. Even if recently, in 2015, the EU has approved in theory the principles of net neutrality, we need to ensure that these principles are applied in practice in each country. How the internet will work tomorrow is going to have direct impact on the sustainability of digital social innovation initiatives that are blooming today. So I think that what we see today, if you haven't had the chance to meet any of the initiatives that are using internet and using digital technologies, I think now we have a nice, let's say, crowd of people in the project area that we can visit. And I thank you a lot for staying here and see you later. Thanks.
Thank you, Zoe. This was very inspiring indeed. Thank you. And so we are at the end of these days, just other 2 minutes in order to spend a few words for this call of solution that the municipality of Milan launched a couple of months ago. Maybe you have noticed that on the left there is a room full of people with stand, etc. We will have a full presentation tomorrow of all this, but in the meanwhile, for the ones that will not attend tomorrow, we would like to explain 2 minutes who are these people, what they are doing, what they are showing over there. Thank you.
Grazie della pazienza e faccio l'annuncio in italiano perché poi i miei ospiti si sentono più a loro agio parlando in italiano. E l'annuncio è che c'è vita anche al di là del corridoio e succedono delle cose molto interessanti. Due sono mostre che parlano di disabilità. Una pone l'accento e solleva l'interesse su una malattia rara che si chiama morbo di Huntington ed è sulla vostra sinistra. All'estrema destra invece c'è una mostra molto interessante che parla di disabilità motorie, si chiama Prospettive Variabili, probabilmente l'avrete già visitata, se non l'avete fatto vi suggerisco di farlo adesso o domani. Nel mezzo invece ci sono le nostre Call for Solutions. In occasione di questa conference abbiamo pensato di lanciare una Call for Solutions all'interno del progetto Open Care che raccogliesse proprio delle idee che sono il precipitato di quello che Open Care ha rappresentato in questi mesi. La Calls for Solutions Open Innovation for Community Care è stata aperta per 3 mesi, ha raccolto idee interessantissime di soluzioni che riguardano sia la disabilità ma anche soluzioni di cura in senso lato. Ne abbiamo selezionato 10 che sono le più promettenti, purtroppo qui ne abbiamo solo una rappresentanza. Domani affronteranno un pitch davanti a tutti voi e davanti a una commissione e il pitch, questa presentazione breve, determinerà i 3 vincitori di questa call. I 3 vincitori poi saranno accompagnati da alcuni dei partner di questa conferenza in un percorso di incubazione e di sviluppo delle loro idee progettuali.